Hello everyone, my name is Sydney Michael and I'm an elementary school ALT with the JET program right now in Hofu City in Yamaguchi Prefecture, and I'd like to give a little apartment tour. I've been meaning to do this since I moved here, but it just kept getting away from me. Now seems like the perfect opportunity, so let's get to it. My situation is unique in that I didn't have a predecessor, so with the exception of a couple things that were actually abandoned here by the previous tenant, and another couple things provided by my BOE, everything in the apartment I either brought with me from America or have purchased since August. I live in a 3LDK, which means my apartment has three rooms in addition to a large living, dining, kitchen area, and it costs about 65,000 yen a month, part of which is subsidized by my Board of Education. This is the outside of my building. It's a little on the smaller side, but it's actually a larger apartment building than some of the buildings other ALTs in my city are living in. There's a little bike parking area on the right. My BOE actually provided all the new ALTs with brand new bikes this year. So mine is parked over there under the little awning for when it rains. On the side of the building, there are mailboxes for actual mail, like mail sent through the Japan Post, and some of those locally distributed free newspapers. The thing on the back of my door that looks like a mailbox is actually for delivery slips and bills, but I have almost all my bills set up as auto withdrawals, so I hardly have anything in there. The lowered area when you first enter my apartment is called the genkan. It's where you take off your shoes and put on either slippers or just walk around in your socks. Looking inside, the first door to the right is the Western style room, next to that is the toilet, straight ahead is the living room and the tatami rooms, and on the left is the laundry, sink, shower room. Over here, we have the Western style room. I've been using it as my bedroom. I got the bed very cheaply on Amazon and I spent very little money. I didn't buy anything I didn't really need when furnishing my apartment. If you're curious as to why I picked this bedroom, the answer is right up above the window, an air conditioner. We came over in the middle of the summer and Japanese summers are both hot and humid. This is one of two rooms in the apartment with an air conditioner and I wanted my bed as close to the AC as possible. This whole wall is closets. The one on the right just has the luggage I used when moving to Japan, as well as a backpack filled with emergency gear in case there's an earthquake or other natural disaster, and the closet on the left is all of my clothes. This black shelf is actually one of the few things that was just in the apartment. I found it in a closet when I moved in. No one told me about it, so it's mine now. The cloth hanging above it is from a festival in Kyoto when I studied abroad, and the framed fan art on the wall I had commissioned in high school. This is the toilet room. It contains one toilet. Something interesting here is that there's a faucet on top of the toilet. I have a little like toilet bowl cleaner in there right now, but you can actually watch the toilet refill with water after you flush and can use that water to wash your hands. It's all clean water that comes down meant to refill the reservoir, but I prefer using an actual sink. This is the laundry sink room. The washing machine was provided by my BOE and the vanity is attached to the wall, but the vacuum and other things in here I bought. Can't really see it right now, but over on the left is the shower. It was a little bit too far to the left in the previous shot so you couldn't see it, but it's different from American bathtubs and showers in that the whole room is the shower. It's not just a curtained off area of a bathroom. You close a sliding door and just spray like there's no tomorrow. This little contraption on the wall is how you control both the hot water and the hot water temperature for the whole apartment, but I only really use it for bathing. Moving further on into the apartment, we'll have the kitchen wall. It's not really even a kitchen, it's more of a kitchen area. My BOE provided the refrigerator and gas range, but I don't cook often because I don't like to. I actually eat kyushoku, school lunch, with my kids at work, which works out to be about 260 yen per meal. Great price for a balanced meal. I didn't have to cook. This is the living room, which is the most lived-in looking room. The posters on the wall were made for me by my sixth graders last year, so I had to hang them up. along with some other photos and trinkets I was given on my 100 yen bulletin board. I tried to keep a monochromatic look because I find it more peaceful, but the desk chair, and coffee table were the rest of the things abandoned in the apartment by the previous tenant. And I don't want to spend any extra money buying things I don't need, so they're here unless they break. This room also has the only other air conditioner in the apartment right up there. This is my TV and TV stand. When I was asking around about cheap places to buy a TV at school, one of my teachers said she had an unused one in a spare bedroom, so she dropped it off for me. Then I found and got the TV shelf with the help of one of my other friends who works at a different school. This is the first extra room that I don't use. It has a tatami floor, which is super cool. I wanted to use one of these as my bedroom, but it was so hot over the summer that the air conditioner went out. I do occasionally pull out a futon to sleep in here for fun though. My BOE provided us with a new futon when we arrived, and per request, we all got a second guest futon around winter break. But I already bought a bed, so now I have three available places to sleep. So these two closets contain those futons and nothing else. This room is connected to the other bedroom and the living kitchen room. This is the other spare room. The dehumidifier was provided to me by the BOE, and I've been using it in the winter to help dry my clothes. Over the summer, I hung my clothes out to dry outside, but when it rains or when it's cold, it takes a really long time, so I found having them indoors next to the dehumidifier works really well. The decorations in my second tatami room are more traditional Japanese things, which I thought might be fun. This room appears to have had an air conditioner in it at one point, but I think that's the air conditioner that's currently in the Western style room, so someone must have moved it. This is the back porch. The sliding doors in the extra room and the living room both lead back here. The view isn't spectacular, but you can see some pretty cool birds out here, and I've seen some cranes in the small field over on the left. But I only really come outside when I hang up my clothes. I hope that gives you a better idea of what my apartment is like. I loved watching these tours after I applied to the JET program so I could get an idea of what it would be like, but I have to say at once, every situation is different. I'm glad I was finally able to do an apartment tour, so I hope you enjoyed it. Everybody, please stay as safe, healthy, and happy as you can. Thanks!